In the third sum, we have to calculate the current ratio and the quick ratio. So first we'll go one by one. So first I'm going to calculate the current ratio. And the third sum particularly, it is a balance sheet sum. So it is very easy to identify the particular current assets and current liabilities. So if you look into the problem carefully, current asset will be given separately and current liabilities will be given separately. So you have to take only those items and you have to put it in. So first write down the formula of current ratio. So when I look into the sum, my current assets are these are the items which are given. So I'm going to write it down and add it up. So now I've written down the values or the items relating to current asset and its respective values. Now when I add it up, I'll get a sum of 6 lakh rupees. So this 6 lakh is my current assets. Now let's move on to current liabilities. So current liabilities are these items which are given to you in the balance sheet. So now I'm going to write it down and sum it up. So I've written the current liabilities item and the values for the current liabilities item. So when I add it up, I get a total of 4 lakhs. So next, let's calculate the current ratio. So current ratio is equals to current asset divided by current liability. So my current asset is 6 lakhs divided by current liabilities of 4 lakhs. So 6 lakhs divided by 4 lakhs. So when you cancel the zeros, you'll get 6 by 4. So divide it until you get 1 in the denominator. So when you divide it, you'll get an answer of 1.5 is to 1. So your current ratio is 1.5 is to 1. So the second part of the sum, we are going to calculate the quick ratio. So I've written down the formula for quick ratio, that is quick asset by current liabilities. Now we have to find the quick assets. So the formula for quick assets is current asset minus inventory or stock minus prepaid expenses. So my current assets are 6 lakhs minus stock. So this current asset, we can take it from the previous sum. That's what we found out in 3-1. Current ratio where we found out the current assets, the same sum. So 6 lakhs, I can take it out from that. And inventories is rupees 1,60,000 and prepaid expenses 40,000. So when I subtract 6 lakhs from 1,60,000 and 40,000, I will get a total of 4 lakhs. Now current liabilities also I have taken from the first part, that is 4 lakhs. So let's calculate the quick ratio. So quick ratio is equals to 4 lakhs of quick assets divided by 4 lakhs of current liabilities. So simple, the answer is going to be 1 is to 1. So that is your answer for your quick ratio.